to live the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel his mighty power and his grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel his mighty power and his grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place.
Good morning. Please stand and join in our opening song of worship found in your gather books, number 496, How Great Thou Art.
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art. How great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees. When I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We begin our funeral liturgy as we begin all funeral liturgies with a reminder of baptism. And so we use holy water to sprinkle this Packer's urn. Baptism starts our journey toward God. And our prayer here today is that that journey is completed where it's meant to be, with our Lord Jesus Christ and in eternal glory. And so let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life so as to open up an entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant, Gerald, Jerry, to be inscribed in the book of life. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Be seated now for our first reading.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and there is a time for every event under heaven. A time to give birth and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to throw stones and a time to gather stones, a time to embrace and a time to shun embracing, a time to search and a time to give up as lost, a time to keep and a time to throw away, a time to tear apart and a time to sew together, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. What profit is there to the worker from that in which he toils? I have seen the task which God has given the sons of men with which to occupy themselves. He has made everything appropriate in its time. The word of the Lord.
Please join in the refrain of the responsorial psalm, Shepherd Me, O God, found in your gather books, number 23.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. God is my so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters of peace. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Gently you raise me and heal my weary soul. You lead me by pathways of righteousness and truth. My spirit shall sing the music of your name. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Though I should wander the valley of death, I fear no evil, for you are at my side. Your rod and your staff, my comfort and my hope. Shepherd me, O God. To love.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus took Peter, James, and his brother John and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became white as light. And behold, Moses and Elijah appeared to them, conversing with him. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, "Lord, it is good that we are here. If you wish, I will make three tents here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." While he was still speaking, behold, a bright cloud cast a shadow over them, and from that cloud came a voice that said, "This is my beloved Son, whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." When the disciples heard this, they fell prostrate and were very much afraid. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, "Rise and do not be afraid." And when the disciples raised their eyes, they saw no one else but Jesus alone. As they were coming down from the mountain, Jesus charged them, "Do not tell the vision to anyone until the Son of Man has been raised from the dead." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, first of all, my condolences, of course, to Betty, Dawn, Kathy, and members of the family and friends who are gathered here. We've gathered to say goodbye to Jerry. We began this funeral liturgy by sprinkling his remains with holy water. As I said, it's a reminder of the baptism which Jerry received so many years ago when he began his journey as a Christian. The water of baptism opens the door to the Christian faith and the promise of Christ to all believers. Jerry was born in 1937, and he married Betty in 1960. They spent 62 years together. He spent a time in the military in the Navy Air Reserves, and he worked for Chicago Northwestern Railroad. And after 11 years there, it was time to move on, and he worked for 3M for 31 years until it was time to retire. And then it was time to choose a warmer climate for the winter. And he and Betty became snowbirds for the past 26 years. There's a time for all things, a time for work, and a time to retire, a time to serve others, and a time to be spent in recreating our own souls, whether that's through fishing or traveling or whatever each of us enjoys. Of course, fishing and traveling were part of Jerry's way of enjoying life. Of course, he had other interests too. The Packers and the Brewers and the Badgers were all part of the rhythm of his life. Jerry even has a certificate that he's a shareholder in the Green Bay Packers, with, of course, all the rights and privileges that that piece of paper has, which just means you can hang it on a wall. The book of Ecclesiastes says there's a time for all things. It lists the big things, planting and harvesting, building up and tearing down, a time for war and a time for peace, a time for living and a time for dying, and many things which, if we live long enough, affect all of our lives. But there must also be time for the very ordinary things, Packers and Brewers and Badgers, working, traveling, visiting national parks. Betty told me that was part of their goal, was to visit every one of them. I know they didn't get there quite yet. And fishing, and yes, even time for telling a good joke. All things have their time. Ecclesiastes is actually trying to tell us that God has providence over everything. His hand is found in all things, all the things which impact God's children, whether they're seemingly good or seemingly ill. Jerry saw that as the hand of that a person is dealt. He lost his sight 16 or 17 years ago in an auto accident, but that was the hand he was dealt. And so with customary humor, it was simply a fact of life. If I can say it, a time to see and a time not to. Jerry had a diamond willow walking stick. And Betty, when I met her and talked to her about what we're doing today, she asked me if I knew what a diamond willow was, and it turns out I do. I actually do. You might think that a willow would be some sort of a soft wood because that's what we're familiar with. But the diamond willow is actually a very slow-growing hardwood tree. It makes this slow but steady progress to produce an intricate but typical diamond pattern in the fiber of the wood. That's where it gets its name from. As all times and seasons are in God's providence, so we might hope the slow and the steady progress of our faith matures in an intricate pattern, a pattern which fits the journey from baptism to the time we meet our Lord. Jerry's life, though, didn't center on work and travel and spending winters in Arizona, as much as that's part of the rhythm of life. It revolved around his family, his wife Betty, his children Dawn and Kathy, the grandchildren, his family and friends. He had a ready sense of humor. He always told me some little joke every time I talked to him. He did. And his humor hung on even amidst the trials of life. I'm told they had a nickname for everybody in the family. You could have to ask Dawn what hers was. And he had a spirit of generosity with his time. He had time for children and grandchildren in 4-H and teaching them to fish at their cabin near Minong, and always time for friends. And he was a man of faith. He trusted in God. That's what faith really means. It means to trust in God. He had faith in God, faith in God's providence, and faith in God's promise in Christ Jesus. That reading that we had from the book of Revelation, it tries to describe the promised reality of unending life for those who believe in Christ. St. John has a vision where there will be a new heaven and a new earth. Former things will have passed away, and God will dwell with his people, and God will make all things new. What we're all meant to hold on to when we face the reality of death is this very promise of Jesus. Christ our Lord came to die for us, that we might live forever. Once we were separated from God by sin, but in Christ Jesus, our sins are forgiven. The old sin of Adam, which separated us from God, is wiped away, and Jesus is the wellspring of the waters of eternal life for all those who thirst. There will be new things, and new things to see, and Jerry sees them now, we suspect. Today is also the Feast of the Transfiguration, And so we have that unusual gospel reading. You don't get it very often at funerals. We should do it maybe more often, though. See, the gospel reading was the story of Jesus going up the mountain with Peter and James and John. Jesus is transfigured. He appears to glow. His face becomes something you can't hardly look at, and his clothing dazzling white. And he's talking to Moses and Elijah, the Old Testament heroes. So you might think that's a strange reading for funerals, but the fathers of the church tell us this. The transfiguration is not because he was God. It was instead to tell us what awaits us in the resurrected new life. You see, Jesus is showing his disciples the glory of the resurrection, the glory of the promise. He just told his disciples that he was going to be put to death, and now he takes Peter and James and John and he goes up the mountain and he shows them what awaits him in the resurrection and the ascension to the Father. Descriptions of all this fail, and all three of the synoptic gospels have this story in it, but all of them are slightly different because none of them can quite describe what it's like. They can't do justice, as St. Paul says, it has not so much as dawned in our imagination what God has prepared for those who believe in him, trust in him, and follow him. The sad reality of death is met by the promise of Christ. If you're true to him in our lives, and if we're true to him in our faith, then he will take us to be like himself, sharing in the glory of God the Father. Our belief is that Jerry will be with him now. That's our prayer, that's our hope, that's our expectation, because Jesus has promised good to those who trust him, and Jerry trusted in all things. That's why he could so easily say, that's the hand I've been dealt, because I can trust it. Because you see, it's not just trusting in something, it's trusting in someone who died for us, and that's important. So we gather this morning to say goodbye, but we also pray that Jerry's passage to the next life may be swiftly guided by the angels. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
Please rise.
We join now in offering petitions for ourselves and for Jerry, to our Father in heaven, who cares for us with great love.
Our response will be, hear our prayer. In baptism, Jerry received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Our brother Jerry was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Jerry seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness of doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Jerry. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let's be seated now as we prepare the altar.
Please join in our song of offertory number 586 in your gather books, Amazing Grace. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound
but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to feel, and grace my fears relieved. A precious deed that grace appeared the hour I first believed. The Lord has promised good to me, His word my hope secures. He will my shield and portion be as long as life endures. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have saved thus far, and grace will lead me home. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, praise than when we'd first
stand and pray, my friends, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all of His holy church.
O Lord, be near, we pray, to your servant Jerry on this funeral day. We offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed, and at your command that we return on account of sin, so to that earth from which we came. And when you give the sign, we who have been redeemed by the death of your Son shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Glory, Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar manner, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, William our Bishop, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember your servant, Jerry, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Stand now and pray in the words that Jesus taught his first disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Please extend the sign of peace to one another.
Peace, Kathy. Repeat, bring peace. Dawn, peace be with you.
the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Join in our song of worship for communion found in your gather books, number 627, You Are Mine.
Peace the world cannot give.
Let us pray. O Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Jerry may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before our final prayers of commendation, just a note that there's a reception after the ceremony at the cemetery, and that'll be at the ridge top immediately following the burial. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Gerald, Jerry, and now we come to the last farewell. There's sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see him again and enjoy his friendship. Although we disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, we console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Saints of God, come to his aid. Come to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God. Present his soul to God Most High. May Christ who called you take you home. May angels lead you to our parents' side. Receive his soul and present him to God. Present his soul to God Most High. Shine on him forever. Receive his soul and present him to God. Present his soul to God Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Jerry in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with Christ on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon him in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and are with Jerry forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace now, we take our brother to his place of rest.
Please join in our final song of worship found in your gather books, Make Me a Channel of Your Peace, number 721.
Make me a channel of your peace.
Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. Oh, Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternity.